Okay, we're dodging rainstorms here. And Sandra has a question. In Q&A 19, you mentioned the chimney for bone char, but say that's a story for another time. How about now? I'd like to know more about bone char and how to make it and use it. Okay, well, I'm back in the same position here. And this is our chimney that we use to make the final stage of bone char. It's a pretty solid piece of steel, so it doesn't burn out. It's got three legs on the bottom, so we can position it well. In fact, we can stab it into the ground like that when this heavy chimney stands up. But first off, we collect our bones, dry out the bone. And when we've got a big pile of dried bones, we make a good fire, get some real red hot embers going. And we put the bones into the fire and we burn the bone. Once we burn the bone, and it goes really dry and brittle. And when it's ashed right down, we get the bone and we powder it. We smash it right up as much as we can, even if it's large, like little splinters, but we powder it up as fine as we can. Then we make another fire and we get it red hot again. And we put the powdered bone into it. And then we red hot embers and we stand this into the fire. So there's your bone, the red embers with the bone, powdered bone put into it after one burn. We stab that into it. So it's underneath there. Then the ideal material and the most convenient material is rice husks. We cover the whole thing with rice husks. So we smother the fire. Now you can use powdered bamboo leaves because what we want is a dry material with a large surface area that's high in silica. That's the ideal material. So we shred up, we put some bamboo leaves under the lawnmower and shred it right up and take it out the catcher and put it on. Or we use rice husks and we pile it up right over the fire with the powdered bone on top of the red hot embers and it smothers the fire. And it smokes out of the top of this chimney. Because it's a tall chimney, it's going to draw the air out here. And what's going to happen is it's going to be a very slow burn. It's almost like a large cigarette ash, slowly turning to ash. And in the end, after that second burn, it's extremely fine. It's colloidal. Now, ash very quickly leaches. So you don't want to leave it out on a day like today, because the colloidal material will wash through and leach through into the soil particles and be gone. Now, once you've got that material, and it's cooled down, of course, you bag it up or you put it in a drum and seal it. And that material's got all the goodness of the bone, plus quite a lot of silica material with the ash from the powdered or shredded bamboo or the rice husks. You can add that then into your compost. You can add it into your worm farm. You can add it into compost tea brews where you're oxygenating, highly oxygenated compost tea. Or you could probably just add it with your mulch to your soil. You've got material that is so fine, it's got such a large surface area, it will feed the organisms in the soil. Now that's all we ever do organically. We never feed the plants really, we feed the soil organisms. And so you've got a beautiful long-term stable material that you can add over time once you've made enough of it. So you've got your own additive as an organic fertilizer feeding the organisms in the soil.